All right, time to power it on for the first time. 3, 2, 1. This is my custom-made breadboard power supply. I've been planning to make one for several years, but I just never got around to it. Until JLCPCB came around and offered to sponsor my projects. We're gonna see if it works in just a few minutes, but first I have to tell you how the idea for this project came to be. At one point, this bulky transformer was what I used to power all my DIY projects. It got the job done, but it was not convenient, not safe, and the voltage settings were way off. Eventually, I got these two breadboard power supplies. They cost about $2 each. Once again, not very convenient because you get just two fixed voltage settings, and in my case, this white one didn't even work properly. I must also mention the Mego portable breadboard power supply. It's a great concept. It has a built-in rechargeable battery and the output voltage is adjustable. I really like it as a product, but a price of $50 puts it outside the budget of most hobbyists. Clearly, there's a gap between these two price points. My goal with this project was to fill it with something functional and practical. It had to be something with adjustable voltage, a voltage display, and safety features to make the device suitable for beginners and hobbyists. Having these design goals in mind, I started searching for a suitable voltage regulator chip. I chose the TLV767 by Texas Instruments. It had suitable specs, built-in protection, a wide range of output voltages, and it was also cheap. There was just this one tiny problem. The chip was microscopic and therefore very difficult to solder by hand. Thankfully, JLCPCB were happy to help. If you need a custom circuit board for your project, look no further than JLCPCB's services. Just like I did, you can design your own PCB using the free and easy-to-use online software EasyEDA. Here is a 3D preview of my design. Isn't it beautiful? JLCPCB can then make your PCB and solder the parts for you, including those teeny tiny surface mount components. All of that is done quickly, with professional quality, and at an affordable price. After a few days, my PCBs arrived straight to my door. They looked awesome, and this tiny chip that I would have never been able to solder by hand was now ready for action. This service is a game changer for hobbyists. JLCPCB is currently running a special discount on 6-layer PCBs. So, if you have never used JLCPCB services, now is a great time to check them out using the link in the video description. A key design feature of my power supply is that it sits on the longer side of a breadboard. I chose to use a bunch of pin headers for stability. They can also bridge the gap in the middle of the power bus of some breadboards. This is a standard barrel jack, so you can power the supply with an old power adapter up to 16 volts. There is also a tiny diode providing reverse voltage protection on the input. I have also included a basic on-off switch. This beauty is a trimmer potentiometer, which is used to adjust the output voltage. I chose this specific part because, unlike other trimmers, this one can be easily adjusted by hand. And if you're wondering why there is so much empty space around the chip, that is on purpose. It is supposed to act as a heatsink. That is also the purpose of these vias I have placed over here. They are connected to the bottom layer, which should help dissipate some extra heat. Finally, here is the voltage display, which I got from AliExpress. You may remember it from one of my previous videos. With a couple of standoffs, it fits right on top of the PCB. Okay, I have my power supply set to 12 volts and a limit of 100 milliamps in case something goes wrong. All right, time to power it on for the first time. 3, 2, 1. Okay, the display is on, which is a good sign, and there is no magic smoke coming out. Now let's flip the switch and see what happens. Alright, the regulator seems to be working. Twisting the knob changes the output voltage. So, yeah, I guess this project is a success. Whoops, I may have spoken too soon. I have a couple of resistors on the output right now, and there's about 100 milliamps going through them. Let's look at the chip through the thermal camera. The chip is quite toasty. I'm measuring over 70 degrees right now. I've added two more resistors to double the load. The chip is still holding up, but it's getting even hotter. I just increased the load beyond 200 milliamps, and it looks like the chip's safety features are kicking in. That explains the drop in the output voltage. As expected, reducing the input voltage from 12 to 9 volts took care of the overheating issue. This type of regulators generate more heat when there's a wider gap between input and output voltage. So, my first version of a breadboard power supply does not perform as well as I hoped. It kind of works, it is usable, but that 200 milliamp output limit is just not good enough. If I ever get around making a better version, I have to figure out how to deal with the heat. One option would be to modify the layout of the PCB, and hopefully that could give it better cooling properties. But I have a feeling a much more effective solution would be to use a different chip, preferably something with a switching circuit. Should I try that? Let me know down in the comments and subscribe to my channel to never miss any of my future videos.